If you want a smooth deployment experience that you get with Vercel or Netlify with all the bells and whistles, but on your own server, then you should probably use something like Coolify, right? But there's also Dokploy, which I'm hearing a lot more about. So let's compare them. They're both easy to install, have similar resource requirements, and use a Docker-based deployment. So you can just add a Docker Compose file, and these tools will take care of the rest. They both let you view logs, access the terminal, and even set up one of the many template projects, as well as email notifications, S3 backups, and much more. Everything you need to deploy and manage your project on a single VPS. But now, let's move on to the differences. And before we do that, why not hack the YouTube algorithm and hit the subscribe button? They both have great UIs, but personally, I prefer Dokploy's. I easily found everything I needed, I preferred the use of colors, and everything just works. Coolify has some weird things, like two save buttons on the same tab, creating a single environment variable would add two, and the copy button here just doesn't work, which was a bit frustrating when it came to deleting things. But Coolify does let you change the proxy from traffic, which is the default, to caddy or something custom. With Dokploy, there's no easy way to change from traffic since it's built into the system, but it is very easy to change the configuration file. Speaking of configuration, when it comes to setting up a project, with Coolify, you can use any public or private Git repository, or you can use a private GitHub repository. And for build packs, as well as a Docker and Docker Compose file, you can only use static for static sites or Nix packs, which may require you to change the project in a way that the Nix pack can understand. With Dokploy, you can use a GitLab repo, a Bitbucket repo, or even drop your project as a zip file from your computer. Dokploy also supports way more build packs, from Nix packs to Rail packs, Heroku build packs, and even Paketo build packs, which I have no idea what that is, but I'm glad that Dokploy supports it. And when it comes to server metrics, Dokploy gives that to you out of the box without needing to configure anything. You can also get project-specific metrics. With Coolify, you have to enable metrics by first enabling Sentinel and then enabling metrics, which gives you CPU and memory and also gives you project-specific metrics. And hey, since AI is being added to basically everything, Dokploy have found a way to add it to your deployment tool as well. You can add an AI API key from Anthropic, OpenAI, or whatever you use, and from there you can create a service using the AI assistant. So I'll click on one of these examples, wait for a few minutes, and the assistant will give me some options and show me a Docker Compose file complete with environment variables that it's created. So there you have it. To be honest, I was expecting there to be a much bigger difference between the two, but they're both great self-hosting platforms, and no matter which one you choose, you'll have a good experience.